What's up, guys, and welcome back to Software and Other Solutions. And today we're talking about Overwatch 2. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, Overwatch 2 is here and it's free to play. If you already downloaded this and you are watching this video right now and you want an FPS boost, guys, that's basically why you clicked on this video. Today I'm going to show you what you can do inside Windows and inside the game to get the best frames per second out of this game right now with less input latency and just an overall smooth gameplay experience with Overwatch 2 that is out right now and that everyone is busy playing right now because the queue is absolutely insane. If you get in, chuff. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, let's jump straight into this video and let's go through the guides that we can do. All right, so the first thing I highly recommend you go ahead and do is go to the search button over here and type in settings, just like this, and press enter and go to update and security. I highly recommend you go ahead and check for updates on your Windows. It doesn't matter if it's a Windows 10 machine or a Windows 11 machine. It doesn't really matter. Just make sure that your Windows is up to date on a regular basis. And then also please go ahead and do this. If it gives you this option where it says download and install on your Windows 10 or your Windows 11 machine, please go ahead and download and install this over here. It's very important for you to go ahead and do that. Once you download that, you're going to click on the home button over here and you're going to go to privacy and you're going to scroll all the way down and go to background apps. Now, a lot of people have this on over here, meaning this is going to run in the background while you are playing your games. All of these things, you might have more things or you might have less things. It depends on what you have installed on your machine. So I highly recommend you just go ahead and switch this off and just keep it off just like that. Once you're done with that, you're going to click on the home page and you're going to go to gaming like this and go to game mode. Now, this is, it literally says on Windows, when game mode is on, Windows optimize your PC for play. Now, there's a big debate about this. Now, for my machine, I'm running a 9700K with an RTX 2060 and 16 gigs of RAM, and every single component in my machine is overclocked. Now, if I turn this on, I do not see an increase in FPS and I do not see a decrease in FPS. If I turn this off, I do not see an increase or a decrease. But you might have one of those machines. It's your own machine. No one has the exact same machine. If you turn this on, you get more frames out of your game and your game is more stable if you turn it on. Then leave it on. That's obviously general knowledge. If you turn it off and it does nothing and you turn it on and it does nothing, then just completely just leave it off and just leave it as is. All right. Once you're done with that, you're going to go to graphics settings over here and you're going to add Overwatch in here. I highly recommend where it says hardware accelerated GPU scheduling. Go ahead and turn this on if you do have this option. If you don't have this option, don't worry about it. I got you covered. All right, so I'm going to show you how you're going to add a game inside. You're just going to press browse over here and then you're going to go to where your Overwatch is installed. Mine's an online games and then Overwatch 2, and then you're going to go into Overwatch. No, it's not this one over here. This is the launcher. You do not want to add this one. You want to go into here and then go into this one over here. So there is the exe file. You're going to double click on it and then add it inside here and then go to options and then go to high performance and let it select your dedicated graphics card or your graphics card that you're currently running and then say save. Once you're done with that, you're going to close out of this. Now, ladies and gentlemen, let's jump straight into the game and I'm going to show you what settings you're going to be using to get the best performance out of Overwatch 2 right now for the best performance in general and a smooth gameplay experience. All right, let's jump straight into that. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, as you can see, I'm in Overwatch right now, so all you need to do is press escape on your keyboard, or you can go all the way down over here and press escape, and then go to options. Alright, now I did go to the sound and put these two things off because it plays music in the background, otherwise you won't hear me. Anyways, video, this is where everything comes into play. Okay, so there's a lot of options for this game with graphics quality, details, and then video. Okay, so let's do this just to go straight ahead into this video. Let's go to details and we do this one over here first. Okay, display performance stats. You can put this on, right? Then it's going to show your frame rate, your GPU temperature, show your VRAM usage, your network latency, and your network over here. So now you can go ahead and turn all of these things on, especially these over here you want to see. If you aren't using MSI Afterburner or stuff like that, I highly recommend you go ahead and turn these things on. All right. Once you're done with that, you can just press Y or you can come down here and click onto this. Now you're going to go to the video tab. All right. You're going to play this at full screen. Please go ahead and play this at full screen. Don't play it in windowed mode or borderless windowed mode. Put it in full screen because the reason why I'm saying put it in full screen is because you're going to get less input latency if you play your game at full screen and the more FPS you're going to be doing inside this game. Now you will do a solid FPS in this game if you change these settings I'm going to show you right now. It depends on obviously the monitor, it depends on the graphics card you're running, the RAM, and obviously the CPU. Now you do get bottlenecks inside PCs. I mean, if you have a really good CPU and an older generation graphics card, or you have a newer generation graphics card and an older generation CPU, then this one over here, NVIDIA Reflex, comes into play. Okay, right. So you're going to put this on full screen, obviously your native monitor that you're currently running, and then your resolution that you're running on your monitor right now, and the refresh rate of that monitor that you are running. So you obviously are doing maybe 60, 120, 144 to 240. Now, if you have a 240 Hertz monitor, you can do up to 240 FPS inside this game. It's very easy and simple. That's just general knowledge, but let's just get over these things. Field of view, I highly recommend just changing it to your own personal preference. I do keep mine on 103 so I can see more on my left and right hand side. This is 16 by 9, so obviously a lot of people have ultra wide screens and stuff like that. Then you can go ahead and change that. It depends on your monitor you're running. Dynamic render scale. Okay, so these things come into play like hugely in this game. So you can just put this off if you want to, or you can put it on if you want to. Now, as you can see, things start changing over here that you can start changing, where it says minimum in-game resolution and then maximum in-game resolution. Now, you can upscale these things and you can downscale these things, right? If you don't want to do that and you don't want to go through all these type of settings, you can just go ahead and turn this off. Obviously, the way it says render scale, put this at custom and you put this at 100% so it does the render of your monitor. All right, frame rate, you obviously want to put this at as high as it can. If you want to cap it to your certain hertz of your monitor, then go ahead and do so. I keep mine as high as it can go. All right, VSync, I turn off. You can go ahead and turn this on if you want to, if you want to cap your FPS to the refresh rate of your monitor, and if you are getting screen tearing. That is what VSync is for. VSync is there for if you are getting screen tearing in your games. For instance, if you are playing and your game starts tearing apart while playing the game, that's what VSync is there for. So it will cap your FPS to the hertz of your monitor, the refresh rate hertz of your monitor, or the refresh rate in general of your monitor, if you put this on. I put this off because I do not get screen tearing, and it's just in general for me, it's my own personal preference. So VSync is your own personal preference. Okay, triple buffering, I highly recommend you put this off, and then reduce buffering, I highly recommend you put this off as well. NVIDIA Reflex, go ahead and disable this, and then this is your own personal preference, obviously, the contrast, the brightness, and the gamma correction. It's your own personal preference on the game. Now, you can go ahead and change the contrast and stuff like that. It does make the game look a little bit better. Colors and stuff overall makes the game just look much, much better. So I have a little setting over here where I make my game 1.30. It makes the color pop out more while playing the game. Every single color in the game just looks much, much better. I highly recommend leaving this at 2.2, the gamma correction. Please leave this at 2.2, and the brightness is your own personal preference. Obviously, depending on the monitor that you're running or the display that you are currently running. All right, then all you need to do is just press Y on your keyboard, or you can go here and it will apply the settings. Then go to graphics quality. Now, here it plays a big role, okay? So I have an RTX 2060 OC, and like I said, every single component in my machine has been overclocked. Now I can play my game at ultra and all of these settings like this without my game doing no jittering, no input latency lag, no nothing. The game just runs perfectly. But if you are running a lower end gaming machine, if you are running a lower end gaming machine, then you're going to have to start tuning things. This isn't that a demanding game on graphics. It's not. But if you do have an older generation graphics card, you're going to have to go and change a couple of things inside you. Okay, so the first thing is obviously your personal preference on what it's going to do. If I put this at low, it's going to change everything inside here. If I put it on medium, it's going to change everything inside here. If I put it on high, it's going to change everything inside here. If I put it on epic, this is how it's going to look. All right, so as you can see, it just gave an option over here. So if I put this on low, that option goes away and it goes back to default. All right. So I highly recommend you go ahead and customize this yourself. So I leave this at default depending on what you use. Okay. If you have an AMD graphics card, you can go ahead and upscale these images. It's very easy to do. There's a few things that you can change, that you can't change. So I highly recommend just leaving this at default depending on what machine you're running. All right. Texture quality, highly recommend either putting this on high or on medium. That's your own personal preference. I can keep mine at high. Texture filtering quality, highly recommend that you do keep this either on ultra or on epic. It does make the game look really, really good. I leave mine on epic and it makes the game look really, really good. All right. Local fog detail, you can actually put this at low or on medium. You do not need this much in the game. All right, this one over here, dynamic resolution. I highly recommend either you put this on off or on low. And then shadow detail, you can either put on low or completely off like this. Okay, so what you can do with the shadow detail is this. If you put this on medium, the shadow's detail, meaning the jagged edges, is going to look a little bit better if you put this on medium. But if you want to completely remove it, you can switch it off. Model detail, I highly recommend either pushing this to high or ultra. The game looks really good if you put it at ultra or at high. Effects detail, you can put this at either high or medium, depending on the machine that you're running. Lighting quality, you can keep it low if you're running a budget gaming PC. So I highly recommend you could either just go over here and change it to this, depending on the machine that you're running. So if you're running a very low-end gaming budget PC or laptop, keep it at low, okay? If you're running a little bit higher, then obviously you're going to put this on medium. If you are running a, I don't know, let's say a 10 series graphics card with a newer generation CPU and 16 gigs of RAM, you can go ahead and put this on high. If you're running anything higher than that, you can go put this on ultra. And if you have a really beast of a machine, you can go ahead and put this on epic. All right. So this plays a very big role as well, anti-aliasing. So this plays a very, very big role. Okay, so if you put this at low with FXAA, the game looks absolutely dog trash. I will not lie. Go ahead and try that out. It looks really, really bad. So I do recommend putting this either on medium or on high. It's your own personal preference, or you can go ahead and put this completely off, and then you won't have any blur happening on your screen. Okay, so this one over here where it says screenshot quality, so obviously you can put this on, just leave it at its default. You don't need to do anything there. Ambient occlusion, you can put this either on medium, low, or high. So, like I said before, it depends on your graphics card you're running. All right. So, with the machine that I'm running, I'm going to just show you what settings I'm using. Okay. So, I put this on ultra and I keep this off because I do not have an AMD card and I do not want to upscale my screen. So, I leave this like this. I keep this at high. I keep this at ultra. I can also put this on epic with the machine that I'm running and I'll still do solid gameplay. All right. This on high, this on medium, this on either off, or you can put this at low. I mean, it is a first-person shooting game, so you do not need the best of settings. So let me show you what I'm using right now. So model detail, obviously you want to put this at ultra or high. I'm just actually going to put this on ultra. And then effects detail, I'm going to put at low because I do not really care about the effects. But if I do want to see a little bit how the game looks great with the effects, I go to medium. Lighting quality, I'm going to keep at medium as well. And then this one over here, I'm going to keep on medium. Right, keep this like this, it makes the game look really, really good. Keep this at high, this at 1x, this at medium as well, and then this you can actually go ahead and turn this off and then put the damage effects either at low like this, or you can go ahead and put it at its default. Default will just keep it at how it is. I put mine at low and then apply these settings. This is the settings I use for my machine that I'm currently running right now. And ladies and gentlemen, it just the game in general, all of these, if this is like this and this is like this, all of these settings over here is like this. All you need to do is go ahead and play around with these settings depending on the machine that you're currently running. I know a lot of people play these on laptops. I know that for a fact, and I know a lot of people are playing this on PC. So, depending on the machine that you're running, is going to depend on what settings you are going to be using. Lower the settings in general, like stuff that you don't need, like shadow details, you know, your local fog details, dynamic, you know, all these things, lighting quality, then you can go ahead and put these things on low. Just go ahead and do that. You'll get more FPS out of your game. Ladies and gentlemen, if this worked for you, leave a like, leave a comment, subscribe to my YouTube channel if you're new here. And yes, there is one more over here, which is camera shake. You can obviously put this at reduced, and then obviously the HUD shake you can keep on or off. It's your own personal preference. Subtitles, you can obviously keep it like however you want it. You can just put it on everything if you want it like that. You can put this on if you want to. It's your own personal preference. Ladies and gentlemen, if this worked for you, leave a like, leave a comment, subscribe to the YouTube channel if you're new here. And as always, I hope this helped you, and peace out.